to be able to be playing a concert with a great friend and colleague, Peter Sykes. You can read his bio and see his picture in the program. He teaches at Boston University as well as at Juilliard. And so we have a lot of teaching in the Northeast, both of us together. And the reason we started playing together is we both have been doing some festivals, teaching at some festivals in the summer, and we would always, on a faculty concert, end up playing a piece together. And we thought, well, you know, we should do more than just one piece every July. And I decided we would try to do an entire concert.
keyboards together, especially two harpsichords, is probably some of the most exacting ensemble experience one could have. The pluck is the pluck, and if you're going to be with it or without it, there's no mistaking either. The next piece we're going to play is a different category than what you have just heard and what you will hear afterwards. This piece was written for two improvising harpsichordists. The only music that we're given is the notes that our left hand plays. And that everything that's in the right hand is made up by us on the spot. This is what a harpsichordist does in a Baroque ensemble when they're accompanying a singer or a flute player in something called figured bass, that they are improvising their accompanimental part. In this, we are improvising something to egg the other person on. These pieces are part of a pedagogical tradition known as partimento, in which students are given part of a piece of a puzzle to solve. And that in this, there's a lot of interplay between the two players, perhaps my master and student, more likely two fellow students, having a great time.
Thank you.
are now going to be on to something considerably more orderly. Johann Ludwig Krebs is best known as having been J.S. Bach's favorite student. His father also studied with Bach, and Krebs is basically Bach's favorite student because he wrote in Bach's style more or less to the letter throughout his life, during a time at which that style was suddenly seen as being outmoded. Krebs really practiced the sincerest form of flattery in imitating pretty much everything Bach ever wrote. For that, he suffered. He never was in his life commissioned to write a piece of music, nor did he hold an important cathedral post. He struggled to feed his seven children throughout his life. But we have this piece, which, had it been written by Bach, we would like it a lot. And we like this one too.
Thank you.
About to cross the Rhine, go back to France. François Couperin is one of the names that we associate completely with French music, and what he's most known for is all of his books of harpsichord music, solo harpsichord music. But he wrote a number of pieces that were actually for more than one instrument, that were for two instruments, and we're going to play a few of those today. There's an Allemande that is for two harpsichords, and there's also a couple of musettes. And the musette was an instrument that was like a bagpipe. It was you had the shepherds out in the fields playing musettes the way people play bagpipes. And what's noticeable mostly about these pieces is that there's a drone that goes on all the time. And so these are two contrasting musettes. You can imagine yourself out in the field if you like, but it's the kind of thing that starts out very contemplative and then goes elsewhere.
And I just want to say one thing about just how much fun it is to play for us together. And secondly, that the Allemande, the first piece we're going to play, is among the most luscious in the entire repertoire. So much so that the movement in the suite which follows is called the afterglow.